The first session with Nile Rodgers was with a brilliant artist called Georgia Smith, and we were writing collectively. And then I came back and did another session with another great writer called Ed Thomas. So it was me, Ed Thomas, and Nile. And it was a daunting experience because of Nile's history and his quality and his legendary status, I suppose. So it was daunting, the first one, but as we got into the second session, it was like, it was calm, and he's a storyteller. He keeps the mood of the room excited, and we wrote some beautiful music. Yeah, being part of the Abbey Road songwriting masterclass for the BBC at Tobacco Docks we had a setup. There was three of us. It was me, Rachel Farner, and Novelist. And it was beautiful. There was an audience of maybe like 350 of all ages, and we just kind of ran through tunes of, there were specific moments of tunes that we kind of broke down and gave a little backstory of what we were inspired by and how we wrote the tunes and how we kind of pieced together from early production to the finished product. And it was just nice. It was informative for me because, you've got young budding songwriters that were asking questions that make you think about your own process and your own history and how you've got to the place you've got and what advice you've given, and you kind of take advice from them. So it was like we were all kind of inspiring each other, and it sparked something in me that I'd like to be actually involved in more talks like that and helping young songwriters in as many ways as possible. My process of writing to visuals started when I was about, it started whenever we got better internet back home, I think. It was probably just after dial-up because I wasn't able to download many videos through bloody LimeWire and dial-up back in the day. But it started off with like pictures and photos that I would source from anywhere, whether it's from a music video that I loved or just a photographer that I loved. And then it came into music videos, and I'd pick like a segment of a music video, I'd download a music video, and then I put that clip on loop as I'm making a song. So it might be 10 seconds, it might be 30 seconds, it might be the whole video. And then I started doing it with films, picking scenes in films, however short or large, and putting them on loop in the background while I was starting to make a tune. Because for me, it felt like as I started to make a tune, whether it was a beat or a guitar loop or just a melodic idea in my mind, I felt like the imagery that I attached to hear what I heard on the song kept me within the spectrum of what I needed to make. So if I felt like I was going off after the first verse, and I'm like, I really love this first verse, but something's not sat right with the chorus, I would sit and watch the loop, and I would take some inspiration, like a bit of guidance of where the tune should go from the visual matched up with the audio, if that makes any sense. And that's kind of something that's stuck with me and has been part of my writing process since I've been 14 or 15.
That's mad. I've never ever heard someone write like that.
Yeah. So I've always got, when I'm writing, most of the time, especially when I'm home, I've always got like two screens on in the background with just loops and visuals just playing.
There's always one clip, or is it like...
Sometimes it's always one clip. Like on my last album, I was really inspired by the Khalil Joseph. He's a filmmaker, and he did a Kendrick Lamar documentary that's like 20 minutes of just like no lip sync. Beautiful kind of like film but documentary style footage, and there was like loads of little clips and moments that inspired different tunes on my record, and I'd find the clip and loop it and write songs to it. To capture melodies and lyrics when you're on the road or anywhere really, it's not even just being on the road, it's just being out and about and things coming to your head, and for me it's just about trying to jot down as much as you can. So whether you're in a pub and something, you hear something, or you think you hear something, or you hear someone might say something. I get more lyrics for me. I get melodies that come into my head, but I think the things when I'm out and about, the stuff that hits me more is like someone might say something or a turn of phrase or a perspective on something. I'm like, oh, that's really interesting. And I'll write down little quotes, or I'll record people speaking or record myself or whatever it is. For me, it's about just jotting things down immediately. I think there's golden moments when you hear things, and it's like, you know what? Nah, I'm gonna take this 2 minutes out at this point, and I'm gonna write this little thing that you said down because it might connect with me or connect with someone else at some point. You know? it's not really unexpected, but I've been listening to a lot of like Carole King, Tapestry, Fleetwood Mac, Talking Heads. Carole King I've always been a fan of, but like the more recently, I think specifically on his last record, certain styles of music and bands I warmed to, and I understood the music that I'd never really connected with before. Especially like, particularly Talking Heads and Fleetwood Mac being two that I'd listened to bits and pieces growing up, or friends or family might be fans of them, but I just never really connected with it. And then in the last maybe 2-3 years, something clicked, and I heard different styles and different bands that I'd listened to growing up and never really connected with, and they resonated with me. So yeah, I'd say maybe Fleetwood Mac and Talking Heads are probably the two that stand out the most. In 2020, personally, I'm looking forward to spending more time with my family, I think, you know. I think that's something in music, sometimes you get caught up in a rat race a bit, and you're always busy or always touring. So I'm looking forward to spending more time with my family, definitely. But musically, I'm sat on so much music. Even before we put this record out, there was a couple of different directions the record could have gone in. So there's quite a lot of collection of music, and I kind of pieced the kind of soundtrack idea in my mind out of the songs that we put on When I Wake Up, my last album. But I'm still sat on like two albums worth of stuff, so I kind of want to piece out in little EPs and build up into another album. And yeah, this has been my first independent album out of my three albums. So it's, you know, and we were speaking about the team, like Hector and Rashid, the directors earlier on, and the producers I've been working with, and it's a whole new team now. It's an independent feeling. It feels like I'm in a really good place anyway, and it feels like everyone in the team around is in a good place to be as productive as possible. So yeah, just more consistent music and more consistent art and more kind of powerful videos, and just as much as we can. That's what I think, that's what I'm looking forward to most, you know.